was contiguous with, it was a contemporary to Ganga Valley civilization. That is a marvelous article, and from that onwards, that's why we are getting a lot of reference in Jatakas, in Pali literature. That is a great, great asset, great source for us. Now it has come only in the last few years. And by the way, when
that Kalinga and Sri Lanka, their relationship, be it cultural, be it economic, any aspect that you look in, very little work has been done. Very little study has been done. Lot needs to be done, as Dr. Patnaik, Sunil Patnaik just now said, that it's not a work of a single person. And I'm really happy to know that this organization is putting up a project to do work on Kalinga and
musical tradition, like the Maori fishing tradition in New Zealand and Australia, or even like Bhatiali songs in Bangladesh. However, these protective deities are in every region, in every country. If we have Avalokiteshvara in Paradip,
in Chandi Purana, that is a conclusive statement. But anyway, we have a number of people from Sri Lanka, and also some researchers from outside. Dr. Srimal Fernando from Sri Lanka had a question. May I request him to unmute himself and ask the question, Dr. Fernando?
Yes, thank you very much, sir. It was really a very insightful session by Secretary Dr. Sunil, and I think our dearest and nearest neighbor is India, and she's our